forget. The doctor's appointment I had before I checked into the hospital, I broke down and just sobbed. My doctor was holding my hand and said, "We're gonna be okay, we're gonna be okay." I said, "But what if not? What if not?" That's really when the guilt set in. Like, I felt like I had committed this crime, and now I was gonna pay for it. This is what you get for doing this again. Now what? And I was thinking. We checked into the hospital. Everything's fine, everything's good. Another long labor though, you know, 19 hours. I was induced, and no complications. It was the easiest birth in terms of just the delivery. You know, Dr. B was joking. He said, "How many times do you think you push?" I said, "Four." He goes, "Two. You push twice and you keep flying out." I was given back what was taken away that 4 years prior. But realizing that was traumatic. Realizing what it was like to be able to bond, I really realized what I missed out on. It hit me like a ton of bricks. I couldn't believe how I felt. I really couldn't. Just being able to hold my child for as long as I wanted. No one has to be whisked away. And of course, after I gave birth, you know, he's stitching me up a little bit. And I'm leaning up, "Is everything okay?" He said, "It's fine, it's fine. You sure it's not bleeding?" Yeah. He said, "It's fine." He said, "Enjoy your baby. Enjoy your baby." And just, I wasn't able to enjoy my first. And so even that, hearing that was very, very traumatic. It took me some time to take that all in. Really realizing what I missed out on was very, very difficult. And sometimes I still think about it. I do. Pretty much every birthday. Pretty much. But here we are. It's 5 years later. And I have an 18-month-old. And I have a 5-year-old. And I'm really, really happy, obviously, that we did it again for many reasons. I'm in awe of what a woman's body can do. You know, and I'm in awe of what many of what you do. You're just very special people. Because you're with people at their most vulnerable moments. People like me. They really need you to understand what their life is like. You come in and you see them at their worst, really. You know, when you meet, we look good. Okay, we have the meetings with you guys, the hair blowing out, look good, the house is clean. When you come after we have the baby, all hell is broken loose. Everything's dirty, messy, screaming at the husband, whatever. I need a shower, you know, all this stuff. But you still do it. You get up every day. And it's really amazing. I'm thankful. Just like I would tell Rachel, I remember when it was like my graduation, you know, it was time to move on. Because then you start talking about stuff that you really shouldn't be talking about. And I'm like, yeah, when I was 10, I was really upset. You know, just because I want to keep going. And, you know, I'm like, oh, we're friends. Are we going to meet for drinks? And so are Rachel. Oh, no, we're breaking up, you know. But the relationships that you form, when you have a patient that you can get to that point, and you like a bird and they're ready to fly, you've done your job. And I don't think you'll ever really realize probably how much they appreciate it, unless you hear someone like me tell you. Because it is the weakest moments, the hardest moments, angry moments, guilty moments, sad moments that encompass all this. All of that with the happiest moment of a person's life. All of that with learning how to be a new mom, new parents, a new wife. Learning to just live a different way. Learning to live with new life. Learning to live with what you may have lost. And so I just want to tell you guys, you know, you won't necessarily get it from your patients, but on behalf of them, thank you. From me, thank you so much. And It was my pleasure to speak with you tonight and tell you my story. Thank you so much for listening. I just really, you know, you guys are a fabulous group, and just really keep doing what you're doing. And I hope that hearing my story just gives you a little bit more insight into maybe sometimes the things your patients aren't comfortable telling you. It's okay, and it's okay to push a little bit. I want to tell you that. It's okay to push them a little bit. Don't be afraid to ask a tough question. They're sometimes waiting for it. I was sometimes waiting for the question to come. I'm more than happy to answer it. I actually want to start the conversation sometimes. But sometimes when Rachel would just ask me a question, that kind of jolt me a little bit. That's good. Because it got me talking more. You know, because sometimes, you know, patients have a way of weaving a tale the way they want to weave it for you. You know, you have to kind of cut through all that.